Today we're going to be talking about the 20mm anti-aircraft gun that you see here, the Ord Lincoln. The Browning 50 caliber really just did not have the punch to take down incoming aircraft, unlike this larger 20mm round. There are several crew members on this gun to make it fully operate. The first position is the gunner, and he's in charge of actually firing the gun. He's also in charge of getting a good sight picture, using the sights, targeting the incoming aircraft, and firing the gun. The second position is the spotter, and he's there to not only help the gunner point out aircraft that are coming in, but he is there to also make sure that the gunner doesn't accidentally turn and hit the ship. The third position on this gun is the loader, and his main job is to really make sure that this gun doesn't run empty. The last position for this gun is the gun captain. So he is there off of the gun with a headset on, listening for information from the combat information center, and he's relaying the information to the spotter on this gun, who's passing that information to the gunner so they can point the gun in the proper direction. And he's not just in charge of this one gun, but several in an area on the ship. With a lot of ships in World War II, they were there to provide an umbrella of anti-aircraft fire, not only for themselves, but other ships like the Essex-class aircraft carriers. So there are several rings of protection. You look at teamwork today within the Navy, teamwork really has not changed. We're lucky enough to have veterans that we can interview about their experiences in World War II. It was really the cohesion, the working as a team, that really helped them get through battle, and it's one of the reasons why a lot of them are still around today. It's because they worked together to overcome those obstacles, and that's one thing that really stands out with the U.S. Navy.